You know there is security audit log, but don't know which events to activate. You already activated it for some events, but should you activate others? I'll tell you my take on that. Hi, my name is Andrea, and today we are going to take a look at security audit logs. It is a tool that has basically always existed. Over the years, it has become increasingly enhanced its potential. But what is it used for? It is useful once activated, as it is not active by default, to track a whole series of events recorded in the system. Each event is grouped into classes, for example, by system events, user, logons, and so on. Each event has a level of importance. SAP has already defined many of them and classified them, but it is possible, though not so common, to add more. One of the most common questions is, which and how many events should I activate? There is only one answer, all of them. There are no events not to be considered. All are necessary. Unfortunately, this is not always applicable for a variety of reasons, mainly related to database or disk space. But why should I consider all the events? Can't I just activate the critical ones? You should activate and manage all the events, and later move them in SIEM. From the latter, critical events would then be analyzed and correlated, defining a data retention and archiving policy thereafter. As we said, this is not always possible due to the space problems and therefore costs, lack of SIEM tools or storage or other reasons. If you already can't, then concentrate on activating events that are considered critical. They should, by the way, be activated in a limited way, in such a way to generate little volume of data and logs. Be careful, as usual, the logs must then be managed. Just like if you activate everything, or if you only activate critical events, but then you don't have a policy to manage these logs, and the events generated then, it doesn't make much sense. If not for detective investigations mode, following then forensically occurring events. Here's what to do in order. Number 1. If you have not already done so, activate the security audit log as soon as possible. Number 2. Activate all events, defining a way to manage logs both as an event analysis and correlation and as data management. Then retention policies. Number 3. If you can't activate all events, activate at least those considered critical, without distinction. And number 4, in any case, define how you want to use these logs to detect non-compliant actions. I hope that I was helpful. Remember to subscribe to our channel if you still haven't. Follow us on LinkedIn and don't forget to visit and subscribe to our blog www.aglea.com/blog if you want to receive periodic updates. Contact us if you want to learn more on how to improve your SAP system security. See you soon. Bye.